Hello, welcome back. Fidasaind here, Caffeinated Gaming. Continue to look at coverage of the recent SolForge Reddit tournament, 256 people. This is the second of the two or three or four tournaments they're running leading up to the Forge Watch Invitational. This is my Shaper deck. It is Necrium Tempest, round one. I already posted in the channel, so go check that out. This is second round against cw8smith, so I'm still in the winner's bracket. This tournament was done best 2 out of 3 with double elimination. There are stream VODs if you want to hear the live commentary. Most of that's just kind of light chatter because it was in the evening and Mrs. was at home working. But let's get into it. So I want to get rid of that Stasis Warden. I do not want it around. I got two choices here. I could Shaper, Magma Hound, and zap it, or I could Shaper and Epidemic. So I'm going to go with the Epidemic route. Probably the better route. He just showed me a Loyan, which means he could potentially have armor. So having things that reduce their life is pretty good. Much better also, much more reliable than things that do damage, like the Magma Hound. The Magma Hound might be a dead card depending on what kind of deck he's running. So cw8smith, right now he's sitting on a 3-1. I'm potentially going to play two Shapers. I might elect to skip one to drop Zemus. Since he's dropped mostly Necrium so far, I'm thinking I'm more likely to skip the Dark Shaper. So, put Zemus out. If you're gonna play Zemus, you gotta play him at low level. Because that's where he gets his good, is level 2, you get him twice, level 3, you get him. Yeah. I still want to know what happens if you get a 5 level 3 Zemus in play. That should totally be an achievement on the Steam list. Having some slight technical issues here. There were a lot of people playing. On top of that, I was also streaming. So I don't know if it's my internet or their servers, but there are plenty of times the game just kind of froze on my turn and it was costing me time. Little tip for anyone that's going to do tournaments, when you challenge someone, just make it so it's not a timed game. Yeah, you can see the game's completely froze, so be back when the game starts up again. Had to reset the game. I think it happened a few times, right? I had to reset the game, reset the stream. Which is why if you watch the stream VODs, they're all over the place. Looks like gave me my time back, though. I'm still at 30 minutes. Now I'm at 35! A little buggy. Do I want Master of Elements or Flame or Dark Shaper? Apparently I wanted Master of Elements. Both of those were okay choices, I think. I believe Master of Elements' choice may have been because he had Flesh Fiend, which means I might need a beefy blocker later. So Epidemic's probably one, and I'm thinking Dark Shaper is the other. Yeah. Take care of that. Still got my 5-2 in play. That's nice. I've taken some hit damage. Wow. That's a hand. The only way it would have been better is if that second Flame Shaper was any other level 1 spell. An Epidemic would have been amazing. A Lightning Blast probably would have been okay. But that's a hand. That is a good hand. So he will drop Flame Shaper on one side, Master of Elements on the other, and then I can Static Shock player, trigger on Flesh Fiend, Static Shock player, trigger on Flesh Fiend. Suddenly, his level 2 Flesh Fiend now trades equally with my level 1 guy. I probably won't be triggering Flame Shaper this turn. I'll probably Epidemic Zemus. Other option is Zemus and Uranti Bolt. That would do 7 damage. Which, conveniently, it's how much I need. Other option, of course, is to just Epidemic, which would also kill his guy. So no matter what, I'm dropping Zemus. The question is, if I don't if I don't epidemic, do I want to block or do I want to let it go past? So we're going to elect to take a little bit of damage on my Shaper, but keep him alive. That move also... Oof, that's a bad hand. That move also makes it so that my Master of Elements is in better shape, too. That's a rough hand right there. So, probably should shock the predator and then call his little guy. I still say shock the predator. There are a few things I have that have six that could do six damage to him. Master of Elements over here, stay away from that thing. Alright, there we go, we're back to good hands now. So we got Flame Shaper, Master of Elements, and a Lightning Blast next turn. Move to lane 1. Unfortunately, he's going to move out of the way, though. Yep. But, problem, dude. Problem. Flame Shaper. Master of Elements, triggers Flame Shaper, kill Grimgott Predator. And then... shock the zombie, 7 damage to him. Now I'm sitting on a near full board with a life advantage. I also just noticed if he plays a level 2, he's taking a beating this turn. Sorry about that. Gonna kill level 2. Seamus probably works just fine. He did not play level 2, so that doesn't work anymore. So let me count. The first 7 obviously goes to that. The afterwards... So I'm going to sacrifice my level 2 Flame Shaper. That probably is an acceptable move. So I got looking at Master of Elements, level 1 Epidemic, and then level 3 Epidemic. That's probably going to force a concede after I do that. That. Ah. And I'm betting cw8smith's going to concede right there. Can't see him blocking all 3 of those right now. And the worst part is not only has to block all 3, but he has to kill the Flame Shaper. So that's game 1. This is best 2 out of 3, so we got to go again. Sitting on 72,000 gold last night, huh? I think I'm over 80,000 now, so I'm waiting to buy more deck slots, or maybe I doubt it, but draft with silver? Somehow I doubt it. Not gold, silver, derp. He is first. I thought that was at 7-2 at first. I thought the hell was at 7-2. All right. Shaper, shock, call the Technosmith, I'm betting. Yeah. Now we got either Shaper Shock Epidemic or Grimgott Shock Epidemic or Shaper Grimgott. I mean, you got choices here. Well, Epidemic is now in the repertoire no matter what. Shocking the Flesh Fiend puts him in range of Magma Hound, which I've already seen, but puts him in range of the other Epidemic. Which, did I draw it? No. Really, there's only one card left in my deck. I'd already seen 12, so it was... I was going to see 10 more, so a 10 and 18 chance to see that card, which means I probably was better off shocking him. So we're going to bolt that guy. Oh, my poor Grimgot. Bolt that guy, and then Scorchmane Dragon. I prefer Scorchmane over Zemus in this case. And then now we got Flameshaper, Master of Elements, is the most likely option. If he forces something, I can blast it. Probably just drop Master of Elements in front of the 5-5, Flameshaper in front of the 7-8. Yep. Which means next turn I could kill off the 7-8. Could cull it. I'm hoping there's a better target for the cull, though. Underlevel Dreadbolt can be... That's why there's only one in the deck. I think I'm going to put Master of Elements down in place of the Scorchmane Dragon. If he wants to sit there, he can, but he can't move over and hit me for 13 next turn. Actually, he would hit me for 9, but that's beside the point. Oof, this is actually going to start to hurt now. So what we can do is we can drop Master of Elements down, and then Lightning Blast. That kills that guy. Sorry about that. Move my phone away. Well, we have to Epidemic. So that's 4, 5, 6. Could shock Epidemic. Shock would have killed the 2-1, but... it worked out, so now he's still on the field. It's one more guy for the Grimgot Devourer to kill now. Still on the defensive, though. This... ooh, he also gave it right to Grimgot. I still think despite that, I'm better off blocking. So I'm gonna tank the hit there, huh? It's not a bad move, but... it could be a scary move, considering I'm about half his life. And I just lost my Grimgot Devourer. So Master of Elements, Epidemic. And I went with Grimgot Predator. Ooh, lots of Epidemic now. So that's going to slow the pace of the game down, which is nice. So that's 5. Let me see. Good! Could kill everything, almost. Actually, can kill everything, completely. Alright, I'm down by 66. The board is reset. Here's a dragon. I'm glad I drew him. would be really bad to have not drawn it after playing the first two versions. So Rar, I'm a dragon. And we can blast one of the 2 5/5s. You could also cull it, but you may as well level up the lightning blast. I'm running out of life, so gotta keep that in mind. I got Grimmot Devourer and your Anti-Bolt. Your Anti-Bolt kills just about anything. Does not kill the Corpse Crawler at level 3, though. Does kill a level 2 Corpse Crawler, or level 1 Corpse Crawler, though. So I think we drop Grimmot Devourer in lane 1, and then we kill lane 5. I don't think I can dilly-dally. I think I gotta be aggressive now. I think no matter what, I should drop Grimmot Devourer lane 1. Let's see. Oh, I remember this turn. I was convinced that would kill him. That was a mistake. I just gave up about a third of my remaining life. Of course, with a 24-24 move 2, he is on the clock also. Grimgut Devourer might be dead. Of course, he could shock Cull. Gonna have to here. So shock, Cull. I think I battle and then move. Oh yeah, I still got a cast left. Master of Elements is the best out of those three at low level. Not sure about moving him over here. It doesn't really do anything. It also gets me out of range of lane 1 in case something kills the Grimgut Devourer. I'd want to be able to block it. He did just feed my Devourer. Rawr. Yeah. So that's lane 2, or round 2. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned to round 3. Bye.